partners. And then we have to see the possibility that if we can translate all the year-long efforts into good research article, which we can submit. Okay, so let me take you through how to write a research article that is going to be our topic. You should be knowing that any research article, if you have seen, and probably you have seen many research articles, particularly postgraduates have read at least 8 to 10, and undergraduates, Prashad and all those people have read some articles I shared based on the experience of a researchers in a foundry and so on. So every research article has got these important, say, headings. Okay. Madam, am I audible to you? And you just make sure that my screen is visible.
Yes, sir, you are
yes,
audible.
Sir.
Okay, great. And the session is being recorded also. So once it is done, probably I'll share this video to all of you if you have missed some of the things. So as I said, any research article starts with abstract. That is a condensed format of paper, actually. It's a very short paper, which is in the form of abstract. And introduction is the next section. Then methodology section is there. Generally, the term methodology may not be there directly as this is. I mean, this wording may not be there in the paper as it is. But maybe some other wordings might be there, like approach, or theoretical background and its application of the method, something like that. So, but then it is representing what methodology the researcher has used while doing that research. And then result and discussion section is the heart of every paper, because this section talks about what you have done. Probably someone is trying to enter into the meeting. You please allow them. So result and discussion section is one of the very important section. And here we need to learn, because many a times the beginners, researchers like undergraduate students and postgraduate students, they fail to discriminate between result and discussion. These are two different issues, remember, and they are not written in the paper with a separate headings, but there is a common heading, result and discussion. And conclusion and future scope, this is the last part of every research article, and this is followed by the list of references. So these are primarily the different headings, or say sections, you have to use. Okay,
Arthur, can you send the meeting there?
Okay, fine. So let me take further, I'll talk about each and every section in detail, and then probably you will learn that how every section can be configured very effectively in order to convince your reviewers that yes, you have done some kind of research and it is worth at least you know, accepting for a review process. Fine. So now every research paper has these kind of questions. See, there are 6 questions I have written on the screen. And these questions, if you answer very effectively, then probably you have done. And these 6 questions are mapped into those sections which I talked about. So these sections, if I say 1, 2, 3, 4, and 5 important sections, if you consider, then these 5 important sections are expressed in terms of these 6 questions. So first 2 questions, see, I have not considered abstract here. Just limit yourself to 1, 2, 3, and 4, 4 sections. These 4 sections represents these 6 questions. So let us see how they are. I mean, what kind of questions each section reflects. For example, if you say introduction, so introduction section should answer, I mean, when you start writing introduction section of your research paper, then you should make sure that your introduction section is answering these two questions. That means why this research question exists in the first place. Why it exists actually, that has to be justified. And second question which you have to answer in this section is, what is exactly the research question which you have answered in your research paper? So these two questions are to be written in the introduction section, but we will see, I mean, in detail, what is mean by this MLRCIO. M stands for motivation, L stands for literature review, then R stands for research work which you have done, research methodology rather. Contribution, C stands for contribution, I stands for implications, and O stands for the outcome, something like that. Okay, I'll just elaborate there in the next subsequent slides. Then, as I said, methodology section is followed by introduction section is followed by methodology section. So what this section answers, basically, it answers to this question: how did you answer your research question? This research question, how did you answer? What was the approach which you used, okay, to answer this question? For example, in COVID-19 pandemic, the question is that what are the symptoms of COVID-19? So that's a research question, because there are a number of questions, symptoms. So we don't know which symptom represents COVID-19 case and which is not. So you have to do some study. And then how did you answer this question represents the methodology section. Then what methodology you have used to answer this question, that what are the important symptoms of COVID-19, like that. Okay, result section. I was talking to you result and discussion section. So what result section talks about, basically, it talks about what did you find, your own findings. It may be number, your observation. For example, you visited to 10 different locations in the country, and then you're writing about your research, that what are the different locations and how they are different from each other. So their number may not be there. Description may be there, that Mahabaleshwar is more beautiful and it has so many plantations and something like that. So those kind of results you have. And then discussion section, how is it different from others? How your result findings are different from the results published by others? Okay, is it better or something different you want to say? So that, discussion section answers these questions. So we will see what the short form I have written in our subsequent slides. And finally, your paper should end with a conclusion. And of course, future scope I have not written explicitly, but it is there. So what is your final opinion about your research? So the summary of everything what you have written here in the first five questions, okay, you answered five questions with beautiful sentences and paragraphs and then numbers. You have to summarize very systematically in the last section. So this represents your research paper. Okay, let us explore these items one by one. Before that, I have some two, three slides to set some motivation for you, that what makes a research paper effective. Okay, so every research paper, any research paper can be effective if these two things are involved. See the graphics. Either you should have an interesting research question. That means your research question is so different and so interesting that people will love it, or reviewer will like to accept it. So your questions should be very, it should not be very common, because see, some questions have been answered. Some topic has been studied extensively for last 20 years and you are again studying the same topic. So then the reviewer will say that, okay, this section or this question has been answered by several researchers, so it's not a new question. Probably in that case, you must have a very interesting answer. Question is very commonly studied by many researchers for last 20 years. but you have very, very different and very interesting answer, then at least you should have this in your basket. That although the question was very old, research topic was very old, but then I have very interesting answer for you. It's totally different, very different and better and great answer I have. So then your paper will be very winning paper in that case. So either of the two things should be there in your research paper, either the interesting question or the compelling or great answer. So if one of the two things are there in your research paper, then probably your piece paper will get accepted, okay, in good journals. See, when you people have limited time, I know every minute you have to utilize carefully, and then every day you have to write something. And see, there should be a clear plan. You know that if the building is to be constructed, then the builder first prepare a plan. You must have observed that there's plan on drawing sheet, then perspective view, and then on computer we simulate how the house will look like, and then we start building it. Otherwise, if you directly ask the laborers to start putting the bricks one over other, okay, and start construction without any image, any good picture on the paper, probably your house will end up, I mean your construction will end up with the wrong construction. I mean that particular construction may not be the right construction which you imagined about. So first is you have to put some design on the paper. So see this is what the person is doing, then he is designing. See, this is extra step. These drawing sheets you will throw away. Once your house is constructed, these drawing sheets will have no meaning. So this is an extra step you are adding in your activity. But although it is useless after construction of your house, it is needed. Okay. So this same philosophy applies to writing a paper. That means you have to prepare some kind of sketch, some kind of skeleton, plan rather. And then you start writing. This is some kind of guidance. So write some plan. And see, this is the best methodology generally I use. Whenever I start writing some paper, I start, okay, maybe I write, suppose, only 10 lines per day. But next day or during that night, I keep thinking that whether those lines have any change whether those lines need to be modified. And then suddenly something happens and then I get up and I rewrite those lines. So this happens. Writing, editing, and then you reach to a very nice paper, nice text material. So it needs efforts, of course. You need time and efforts. But believe me, if you just write, edit, improve that quality of those paragraphs, you will end up with very beautiful and very appealing, attractive kind of document, and you will be satisfied. Okay, your satisfaction is more important than the reviewers then. And sometimes what happens is we set very high bar. I mean, we expect very, very high level of content to be written. And then we do nothing. We just look at the screen and we do nothing. It happens sometimes. But instead, write small things and keep editing to improve. So this is the graphics that shows how you can write step by step, and then you can reach to the goal instead of just waiting for something, accepting large target at the, in the beginning only may not work for you. Anyway, this is a PhD level discussion basically. But then I thought I should. Okay, so I will just take you through abstract very quickly, how just generally this is written. I'll be sharing this presentation also to all of you, and then the video recording also, so that if at all you have to revisit, you should be able to revisit and rewrite the things. So when you decide to write an abstract, then remember these points. Like it's a concise summary of entire paper. See, abstract represents entire paper. That means if someone reads your abstract, then he or she should be able to understand what exactly is done in this paper, what method is used, and what are the findings, and why this research is done. Everything. Why this research is done, what is done, how it is done, what is found, everything should be mentioned in the abstract. It should have maximum 200 to 400 words, generally half page. Okay, it gives idea about project background, the reference or relevance of the research paper. I mean, why this research was important, that you answer here. The research hypothesis, that means, I don't know this term is clear to these undergraduates and postgraduates. Hypothesis is something that you decide in the beginning only that this is all about.
Hello.
Okay, so yes, it should also talk about study design. Okay, I'll just take up. What was learned and statement of conclusion. So these are the things there. Okay. Okay. Let me just take you in detail. I mean, let me talk about all these points in detail about abstract, because you will be writing abstract and then your professors, your guide, instructor will cross check it. So see how it is written. Many things, but then I'll try to summarize very quickly. First two sentences. The first two sentences you should write what is known prior to publication. So first two sentences should talk about what is known till date. Okay, one sentence of what knowledge gap this paper is going to bridge. So one sentence is about what is known prior to your research, and then one sentence is what knowledge you are going to add. See, two things are to be written here. First, what is existing and what new you are going to add. That sets the motivation for the reader. No citations, nothing like that. Do not copy and paste from the existing literature. These are certain instructions. I think you understood these two sentences. First sentence is what is known, I mean background, and what your paper is going to add here. That's the that is to be written in the beginning. Then next sentences, third sentence and fourth sentence. Okay, here you have to write your research problem. Okay, I have written something, but listen to me, that what exactly what you intend to do in this research work. So your research problem has to be stated using sentence 3 and sentence 4. Okay, let me repeat. Use one or two sentences to define your research problem which you are going to solve. This is your third and fourth sentence. Fifth and sixth sentence, that what methodology you have used. That state the strategy, approach, methodology you are going to use to solve your problem. So what problem is there, that is written, and then how you are going to target or attack this problem, that you are going to include here. And include the scope of your study. I mean, see, your study may be very big study, but you cannot do so much of study, I mean, about your topic. So in this particular part, I mean sentence 5 and 6 should talk about the scope of your study, limitations, whatever. Use maximum two sentences. I hope this point is clear. Okay, we are going sentence by sentence here, and then we have done with six sentences so far, 7 to 9 sentences. So here you are summarizing your results. Okay, so few sentences, few means only you have scope to write 2 to 3 sentences to summarize your research finding. Okay, maybe you have evaluated data, whatever, or specific relation that you have found. So in short, you are going to write here briefly your findings, your result findings. So I think you got you got the idea about how to write this abstract. So why you have done the research, 2 to 3 lines. What exactly you have done, 2 to 3 lines. How exactly you have done the research, 2 to 3 lines. And what exactly you found, 2 to 3 lines. That's all. Even you can add one line, that what is the importance of your research, I mean, what is the important application of this research in general. That sentence you can also include after you have summarized your important findings towards the end of this paragraph. So this is a one paragraph activity, that's an abstract. Hope this is clear to you. Okay, now I'll get into the introduction section. That is very important. Abstract section is also equally important, because once you submit your research paper for certain journal, what happens is your journal authority will read the abstract. And if they find that, yes, this research is important, timely, it's not very old, it is a trending research or something which is trending, if you prove there, or if your English is excellent, you should not make a grammatical mistakes, or you should not have copied and pasted anything, because they have got powerful softwares, and those powerful softwares will immediately find out if you have done copy and paste, and they have powerful softwares to find out if there are grammatical errors. So you are not permitted to include any grammatical mistake in the abstract. Not, I mean, throughout the paper, you should not have a grammatical error. Neither any part of your paper is copied and pasted, because once you do it, you will be spotted in that activity, and then probably you and your guide may be even blacklisted by that journal agency. So avoid doing all those things. Fine. So introduction section has got seven, parts. It doesn't mean that you are going to write seven paragraphs, but roughly there are seven parts. So let us see what are these seven parts. Listen this carefully, because you have to write it. You do not have other option other than to write these. And you, if you do not write the way I have written here, then probably you will not leave a very good impression to the office of editor where you are going to submit the journal paper. Fine. So the first paragraph here, you have to provide a background information about your research work. So the first paragraph will talk about the background of your research. For example, my students are working in foundry. So background about foundry, when the foundry business started, and then how this foundry business is important, and what are the different practices and all. So that background should be included in the first paragraph. Then second paragraph, in this second paragraph, you have to introduce very specific topics of the research, okay? Because this may be very broad. First paragraph may be very broad and very general, but you are doing a research in a specific part of this entire background. For example, I said foundry. So foundry is a big topic, but say you are doing your research in, say, only energy auditing activity. So here you should now introduce specific topic of your research. Okay, that means you will start talking about energy auditing in a second paragraph, and why it is important to conduct the energy auditing or some data analysis. That should be written here. So first part is the important background of the foundry. Second part is specific to your research, whatever you have chosen. In third part, you have to now see these two paragraphs are done. Okay, this paragraph, this is a 6 to 8 lines. This is 6 to 8 lines done. The third paragraph, for example, mention the past attempt to solve the research problem. That means now you have to gradually talk about the literatures available. So you have to check the literature. In fact, you have already done literature review. That is my assumption. So you have, suppose, 8 to 10 research papers which you have already read. And then about those 8 to 10 journals, you are going to mention here as a part of literature review. So the third paragraph is essentially a literature review, where you are going to write what the past researchers have done and what the past researchers have not done. So you are going to find out the gap in the literature. So let me read this. Mention past attempts to solve the research problem or to answer the research question. So here you have to cite all the citations. means whatever papers you have been reading, you have to mention about those papers here. So third paragraph is done. Now you are in a fourth paragraph. So in fourth paragraph, you have to include your research concept. So your own research concept, what is the framework of your own research? What is your research idea? What is your research problem? That you have to briefly mention here. So that is the fourth paragraph, for example, which exclusively talks about what you intend to do. What is there in your basket that you are going to write here. Then the fifth paragraph is all about, say, your objectives. Here, say, for example, in general, you have written a topic about what research you are planning to do or you have done. Then here, specific objectives you can highlight, and then that represents your contribution. Sometimes this fifth point is written by considering bullets. You know the PowerPoint bullets are there. So in Microsoft Word also, you can have a bullet, 1, 2, 3. So these are your research objectives specifically, which you have you set before the research, and then you have tried to address or solve each research objective. Fine. So you have done with the fifth paragraph where you have highlighted your research objectives. Then comes your sixth paragraph, which talks about the implication. That means what is the impact of your research in general in the existing research which is already going on. So you can write here 2 to 3 lines. Okay, this sixth item can be clubbed here, or it can follow this item number 5, and it may not be a separate paragraph as such. Okay, and this need not be in the bulleted form also. Maybe this is one paragraph which talks about your research objective, and then in the same paragraph you are talking about how your research will have impact as far as the existing research is concerned. Maybe it's an industry application, you can write something like that. And the last paragraph is generally how the rest of the paper is organized. That means what is going to come next, that you have to write. So hope you understood how the introduction section is generally configured. And there are, you can see, 4 to 5 clear paragraphs, each of 8 to 10 lines you have to include. So abstract is a half page, and this may be 1 or 2 page, maybe up to 2 pages. Okay. So this is the introduction section which you have to configure. Okay. So I'm not taking a question here. Probably if you're writing down on the paper some questions which you have in your mind, I will allow to talk to you once we have done with, because there are many slides I have to deal with. Okay. So now we have done with abstract and introduction, and as you know that there are these many sections. So we have done with these two, and now we have to do with these remaining three. So I'll just touch to the methodology section and then the remaining three sections. Okay. So let me jump into that section, methodology. So what is basically goal of the methodology section? Why should you include this section in your paper? Actually, it describes what did you do to get an answer to your research question. So there was a clear research question. So I'm using the word research question. It means, for example, a foundry people. The research question was, is there any wastage of energy in a foundry? That was your research question probably. Similar to this question I told you, you people have spent 2-3 months in a foundry. You should have several questions in your mind about the foundry. So those are all the research questions you are going to answer. Maybe in your research paper, you need not have only one question, but you may be answering 3, 4, 5 questions. Okay. So those are all your objectives basically. I hope you are getting what I mean. So goal of methodology section is to describe what you have done actually. I mean, what is the procedure? What is the strategy? What is the approach you have used in order to say, in order to answer the research question or in order to solve your research question. Okay, I'm using the word answer. You can use the word solve also. So this section describes the method, describes what you have done to solve your research problem. That is how you can state this sentence. Your research may be of any of this kind. See, I have broadly written these different kind of studies, empirical studies, experimental studies, computer simulation studies. Empirical study means Newton and those people, they did a research and they came out with, say, for example, force is equal to mass into acceleration. That's an empirical study they have done. Or maybe those scientists came out with some concepts, some Newton first law, second law. So those were the all research, because Newton published all the findings in a journal of physics. And then all those journal papers by Newton and those people, they became a syllabus of the school level studies later on. Okay. So essentially that knowledge was created by those people and they published in a standard journals, and then eventually that was simplified and that became a curriculum and syllabus of school and higher level education. Fine. So it may be empirical study you have done. You may have done experimental study in the laboratory. For example, in chemistry laboratory, you are mixing several chemicals and then, you know, you are checking the properties of a chemical, or some kind of inverter you have designed in your laboratory and then you are doing experiment on that inverter and something like that. Or the experiment work can be used if you have been teaching to the student and then you have used four different methods of teaching to student. So you are conducting four different experiments and then you conclude that the first method of teaching the student is very good. Second method is not that good. So these are all experimental studies. And you have done some computer simulation study where you collected a lot of data. Then you did some analysis, maybe some methods of computer simulation you have used. And then you found some interesting answers to the problem. So these are all different kind of studies you must have conducted or people are conducting, and then they are writing technical document. So see, methodology, what is the characteristic of this section? If someone reads your methodology, then they should duplicate. Okay, you have done research that how to say, how to teach electrical machines to the students. Okay, you found a new idea to teach electrical machine subject very effectively to student. And now you publish a paper that if DC machines, this topic is covered in the classroom by using these five techniques, then student learning is excellent. So if someone duplicate in their classroom, copy, I mean duplicated, then he or she should get same results. Or you have done an inverter, designed an inverter by using some XYZ method, and then your inverter is now, you know, you sold the inverter in the market, and then you publish the paper that if you design an inverter, the total harmonic distortion is only 5%. So, and you clearly described the methodology of designing the inverter to get total harmonic distortion less than 5%. And if someone uses your same approach, then that person should also get total harmonic distortion less than 5%. So that level of description you should give in your research paper about what method. Say, for example, our students are working in foundry. So how they have done the study, what is the approach they have used to do the study in the foundry? That method that you have to describe, that okay, you have done these, you took the reading, then you do the, you did these, then you did analysis, then you took the reading and whatever, and then you found some results. So if someone reads your paper and goes to the foundry, and if they uses the same approach, then they should get same results in the foundry. That you have to write. So that represents the methodology section. Okay. So how you write a methodology section? I have written many things, but when you start writing a methodology section, see, it may be different for different type of researchers. That means someone is doing research on COVID-19. Someone is doing research in foundry. Someone is doing research in, inverter design. And someone is doing research in, say, agricultural field. okay, to check what is the productivity of particular seeds. If a particular seeds are put into the farm, then that crop is excellent. That research is he is doing. So everyone has a different methodology. So there is no ready-made dish, and this ready-made dish I will give you, and you people will eat that dish, and you will become very master to write a methodology. It is not going to happen, because the methodology is different for different experiments which you have done. So you know better how to describe your methodology. So while you describe the methodology, you have to identify your headings and subheadings. So you should be smart that how should I describe methodology? What should be the main heading? Then what are the different subheadings? And what should I write under each heading and subheading? That skeleton, a sketch you have to prepare, a plan. Just like a director who is directing a movie, then he decides that whether the songs are to be screened first, or fighting should be screened first, or some kind of scene to be screened first. So he or she visualizes how the movie will be seen by the people in the theater. So you have to create a map of this methodology section, and then you have to start writing, and you may be required to change every now and then, because you will, after writing, understand that no, this is not good going. You may change again, you will revise, this is all going to happen. Okay, and then final version will come out, which you will believe that is the best version you have created now. So if you are confused, for example, my foundry students, they are not any researchers, they are just doing their BTech studies. What you can do? Yes, you can read the similar journal papers. Okay, check the titles given in that paper, and then do not copy and paste, but try to think and create similar kind of headings. Which you think that, okay, they are right headings now. So this kind of suggestions are given here. So once you have done all this activity and you are done with headings and all those things, then you start writing research methodology in detail. Then you have to restate your question again. See, while you start writing methodology, maybe you can use one or two lines that what is your research question? What is the research problem? But now, you every time you mention about your research problem which you have solved in your paper, you have to make sure that your language is different. I mean, you're not copying and pasting same line 3-4 times in the same paper. It is a very bad idea. No two sentences should be same throughout a paper. That you have to make sure. Okay, so you restate your research question here, but you will be smart now here to redefine in a different, to define the same point in a different wording. Okay, so having done this in a 2-3 lines, then here description of your research design. See, you are writing a theory here, for example. Okay, if you design a buck converter, and to design a buck converter, you have used some XYZ method, which is different from the past researcher. So first of all, you will describe here what is buck converter, conventional buck converter, and then what is the new description, I mean what is the your new version of a buck converter. So that description of your research, how you have designed that new, what are the formulae you have used, what is the logic, that you have to mention here in the second paragraph. So your first paragraph of 2-3 lines was your research question. Second paragraph, of course, choose a suitable heading here. Okay, then you have to mention again here why this research design is the best you believe. That means you have described your methodology, which is different from the methodology of other researchers who have done the similar research in the past. But you have to justify here that why this design strategy is a great strategy, you think. Okay, so that justification should come in picture. Just plain dish without any salt will not have any taste, right? So you have to add flavors, make your dish very tasty, and then your reviewer will love to eat it, right? So that you should be smart here. You have to, without any hesitation, mention the limitation of your strategy. See, you are not ideal, I know, and neither me, no one is an ideal here. Every research has a limitation, but we should be smart to mention these limitations. And while you mention limitations of your approach, your strategy, which you have chosen to solve your problem, you should be very smart that this limitation is not going to create inaccuracy in your research. So that you have to write. Okay, I think I told you. These are the four points I have just highlighted here. The 1, 2, 3, and 4. These four segments represents the methodology section. Okay, but use suitable heading for your own paper. Okay, I think you are getting what I'm trying to tell you. I know this presentation I'm just rushing through, and I'm very fast because time is a constraint for you and me. But I will be sharing this content again, so you can revisit if you have missed something or something you have not understood. Okay, you are going to restate your question in the beginning. Okay, reword the problem so that it will connect to literature review. See why you should write this research question in the beginning, because just you finished the literature review. So you are just trying to connect this your research with the literature. See, literature review does not mean that just for the sake of literature you are writing. Literature review means you have to mention about those literatures which are very closely connected to your research. It should not happen that you have done X research and you are talking about Y research. Means you have done research about COVID-19 and here you are talking about swine flu and viral flu and those literatures you are mentioning. No, if your research is related to COVID-19, then all the papers should be from COVID-19, and you have to make sure. Now the COVID-19 is a pandemic in 2020. So you cannot have any paper of 10 years before where COVID-19 virus was not existing. So surely your research literatures are going to be from last 1 year only. So same thing you have to keep in your mind while you write this literature review, that you are talking about the recent literatures. It means that you should have maximum papers from last 2 to 3 years only, and very few papers may be very old, because you have done research which was old, you believe. Maybe 10-year-old problem you have solved, 20-year problem, 20-year-old foundry people, because foundry is existing for last 30, 40 years. So there are many papers very old. So you may have 1 to 2 paper very old, 10, 20 years old. But then most of the out of 10 papers, suppose you have mentioned here, 2 paper may be very old, but 8 paper should be very recent, from 2017, 18, 19, 20, like that. Okay. And we were here actually. So reword your problem and try to connect with the literature review and methodology. Okay. That's one thing. Now the second point here, description of your research design. So description of your research design. This is a heart. See, you are going to describe your own contribution. What methodology we have used, which is different from the other methodologies. See, journal paper does not mean that you are just duplicating somebody's research methodology and you are claiming that you have done research. No. If your problem is old problem, you must have new methodology. Your problem itself is new, then methodology does not exist. So whatever methodology you propose will be accepted. That simple. So heart of research paper has a heart, and methodology is a heart of your entire research paper. It should be clearly explained. Okay, I mean, it may be a process. For example, COVID-19 research is going on, so how you are collecting data of patients, that becomes a methodology. Are you visiting to patient's house, or are you circulating Google form, or are you calling them? Are you sending WhatsApp messages to collect the information from the COVID patients? So that becomes your methodology. Or when you are working on with a foundry while doing auditing activity, how did you do that auditing? How did you collect the data? What was the method used? How your approach was different? or maybe your analysis might be different. For example, methodology was same as earlier researchers, but your analysis is different, or something is different that has to be highlighted here, okay, in methodology section. It should be detailed enough. I mean, why it should be detailed enough? You should not have a very short methodology mentioned, because if someone reads your methodology, then other researchers should duplicate. Okay, they should go to the laboratory and they should mix up the chemicals and they should get same results. Or if you have done some simulation, then other researchers should go and copy and paste your simulation, and he or she should get similar results. That indicates your, I mean, that will be a good quality methodology paragraph. Okay, so I think you got this point. Justification. See, in the third part, you have to mention that why you believe that this methodology is going to yield best results. So you have to justify. Just mentioning your methodology is not sufficient. Your reviewer is very eager to know why you have chosen this approach. For example, you are studying COVID-19 patients. Then you mentioned Google form was circulated. Then you should justify why Google Scholar. You can say that COVID-19 patients cannot be visited. I mean, we cannot visit to the house because it's highly infectious disease. And now these days, internet technologies has improved, and the computer literacy has improved. So this is an excellent tool to reach to the people. And yet the infection will not spread. So that is how you are justifying why Google form is the best tool to collect the information. So for your research, you should justify that why XYZ approach was a really excellent approach to choose and to implement. Okay. And try connecting everything you write with a literature review also, because your methodology, what you have chosen, may have some connection with old literatures also. So you have to cite those articles where your methodology is close to earlier methodology. Okay, that you have to take care of. And you have to convince why methodology chosen is a thoughtful and tailored response. That means, see, you have to mention that your methodology was chosen by a lot of thoughts. It was not just arbitrarily chosen methodology to solve that research problem. And also, you may mention that similar methodology exists in the literatures, past literatures, but you have modified that methodology to suit to your problem. So your methodology is a tailored response. You are not just copying and pasting somebody's research methodology, but you are making slight changes in that methodology, and it is a tailored response to the research question. So I hope you got this point. Let us move to choice of method limits. See, yeah, I told you that there are 4 points you are going to write in your methodology section. So the last point is describing about the limitations what are the shortcomings, limitations of your research. But I want you to be very smart here. See, you have to mention it that, yeah, this method has these limitations. But you should be very smart to mention that there's no regret. This limitation is not going to create a big problem in your research. There is any hardly loss of accuracy in the research. So you have to justify or mention that although there is a limitation of your approach which you have used, but still, the result you will be getting are close to the expected or the practical results. And therefore, the reviewer also will be very happy that you are a very honest writer and you have mentioned your limitations upfront. Okay. And yet you are smart enough to mention that your limitation is not going to create big problem as far as the results of your research is concerned. Okay. Done. Now we are entering into the result section. What is the goal of result section? Describe the results without interpretation. You are just going to describe your results. You are not going to interpret them. Okay, interpretation will be done in the next section, which is called discussion section. Use past tense because you have done the research. So preferably most of the sentences you have to frame and those sentences are going to be the past tense. Okay. Then I think you got the point. What is the goal of the result section? Some decisions you have to make before you start writing this section. Okay. So what are the decisions you have to take before you jump into this section while you write your research article? Yeah, you have to decide whether you have to go with these kind of tables to very well describe your results. See, such a graphics can be very catchy and your reader may be very happy. They love to study anything from the figures. You also know that while you read the book, if there are a lot of figures, you are very comfortable. If there are a lot of text, probably you will feel very boring and then you will have a lot of resistance to read those sentences, but the graphics will help you understand better. So you choose, because sometimes your research does not have a graphics, but there are tables. So then decide whether table gives a better idea or whether graphics gives a better idea, but don't use both. I mean, your graphics as well as figure, a table, then that will not impress your reviewer, okay? And accordingly choose some subsections. See, again here, when you write a result section, you have to choose some subheadings. 2-3 headings you may have, depending upon your, maybe foundry people, for example, they are going to write a result. So maybe a result of X department, I mean, you've done a say study of thermal and you've done a study of electrical part. So you can say that results related with the thermal apparatus, results of electrical equipment. So you have 2 sections now. You may have 3 sections, 4 sections. So choose the subheadings, suitable subheadings. Okay, that depends on the scenarios, something like that, situations in your research paper. Okay. So I think I have this. You have to write table number, figure, all the captions you have to show. And this table should be like this. Okay, see how beautiful this table is. Instead of having so many columns and rows, this looks very good. So choose this kind of formats. Okay. Short paragraphs. See, main heading, short paragraphs. See, whenever you start writing, you will have main heading. So main heading will be followed by a short paragraph, say 2-3 lines. And then subheading starts. So subheadings are generally in detail. So you should remember this. It should not be a main heading is having a lot of description below it and subheading is described by 2-3 lines. No, it doesn't sound good. Result section. I think many things are there in a result section. So maybe let me continue with the same pace because it is being recorded. So detailed version should help you later stage. Okay. It may take a little more now, maybe 10 minutes more. See the outline of result section. Okay. So this is what you did before you study. Okay. Sometimes see, you might have done some extra things. Your research was one part, but while doing research, you did some extra thing. So you have to describe that extra thing also. Okay. Maybe say you have done some data, you combined the variables, data transformation, something you have done, which is not directly a part of your research. But you thought that this should be done in order to describe your research in a much better manner. So those things you can also include in your result section in the beginning. Okay. Maybe some data you have taken from some literatures. So you can mention, okay, the result is as result section, under the result section, you may or you should include some data which you have taken from some other papers also, okay, which is not your result. I mean, this data does not represent your findings, but you have taken from some other paper which you have used. For example, IEEE test system data. So you have to mention those data in the beginning, and then you have used that data to solve your problem. So the first part of result section talks about writing some data, some information which you have collected from other literatures, or you yourself created some data by some say mathematical analysis that you have to describe in the beginning, so that reader will know some basic things about the result, and then actual result you are now going to describe here. So it is going to have the four components. So result section has essentially these four components. Let us see what are these four components one by one. So what are the main studies? This is the question which you are going to answer in your result section. So the first part is, what is the corresponding research question? See here, when you start writing result section, you have done all these things in the beginning. Then you have to restate your question. Tumcha problem, your research problem or research question, you have to again reproduce here. See, you have written here that part while you started talking about methodology, you have restated question. Now again you are restating the same question. But now you should be smart. You should not copy and paste same thing. You have to use different wording, different type of sentence, but meaning will remain same, because you have only one or two questions, whatever two, three questions you have solved. So again, you are redefining here under result section, but using different wording, different sentences. Okay, just to connect. So you are trying to connect your result section with this research question. That is the point here. Okay, second part of this result section is, what analysis study you considered? Okay, maybe you can briefly write about what analysis and case study you have considered in this section. So you are describing the case study analysis. Okay, for example, a study of COVID-19 patient in Islampur city was my research problem. Okay, so you have to mention about population of this Islampur city and which area and what, and something like that. Some brief about that specific case study or specific analysis has to be mentioned here. And this will change from research paper to research paper. Foundry people will have to write here that a case study of one of the foundry in the western Maharashtra was conducted, and the data or this type of data was connected, it was analyzed by using the XYZ method or something like that. So these few sentences you have to write here. Okay, and now the main part. See, up to this you are just writing some related things, but exact results you will write here in some third paragraph. What are the exact results will reflect here. Okay, so this is the result section I'm talking about, and in the third part. So first part was all about some data or some extra work you have done, that you have to write here. It may not, it's in some of the research paper, it may not exist even. Not necessarily this paragraph may be there for everyone, but if at all it is there related to you, you can always use this first paragraph. Second paragraph and was all about answering these two points. That is, you restated your research question and you briefly mentioned about some case study. As I said about foundry, you are talking about foundry. See, your company is not going to allow you to write a name of company. Okay, so here in this paragraph, what you will be writing in this study, case study of say a capacity of that foundry. For example, that foundry is producing 1,000 tons of cast. So you can have a sentence like, a study of a foundry in a western Maharashtra which is producing 1,000 tons of casting material is conducted in this research study, and something more you can write if you have something in your mind. And then you can mention that all details, the results are given in the next section, and the next section will start. Okay, so here you are writing your results. So maybe table is there, some data you have analyzed, table, graphs, whatever you start mentioning about in this. This may be a one page activity. Okay, so this result section may be entirely one or one and a half page activity, depending upon the volume of research you have done. you do not interpret these findings. That means in this section, in this part of your writing, do not compare your results with other studies. You have to avoid it. So hope you got this point here. Now, I think I told you everything, and first paragraph, second paragraph, how it is to be conclude the findings. Okay, so this is sample outline. You just read and then implement. I will not go through right now because of the time constraint. Discussion section now. So discussion section is to convince the reader that how your results are very useful and very valuable. Okay, so the goal of discussion section is to show that you have very convincing and valuable answer to your research problem. Now you start convincing. You have given your results, but you are not convincing in this section why your results are very important and all those things, comparison analysis. You're not giving in detail. You're just giving numbers, graphs, tables, okay, data. That's your result which you are describing here. Now in discussion, you will do the postmortem. Okay, you will do a dissection, postmortem, comparison analysis in the discussion section. So see, this is what I have developed. Basically, this slide is not taken from any research paper or from any presentation, YouTube, anywhere. My 25 years of experience has produced this particular slide, and I believe that if you write your discussion section using these blue colored headings, then you will reach to the reviewer in a much better manner. Okay, so this is a general template I have created. So see, it has several parts. Discussion section has several parts. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 parts are there. Okay, so as I said, you have to convince. It should be convincing, and you should prove that it's valuable. Two different things are there. Convincing, your results are convincing and they are valuable. These two things you have to mention. So now when you start writing discussion section, okay, then you have, again, remember, you may have a discussion as a separate heading, or it may be part of result section. So if your heading is result and discussion, then you should not restate your question again, because already in the beginning you have restated your question. Okay, so avoid again redefining here. But surely you can write one or two lines about methods and something about results, or you better avoid here because you are going to write result and discussion section as a single section. Okay, here you have to start interpretation. I mean, like, your sentences will be such that they are going to answer these questions. What is the meaning of result? You got a result, but what's its meaning? You have to interpret here. So state if it has several interpretations. Say, for example, if it has many meanings, then accordingly you have to write several interpretations. So I think interpretation means you are describing here what is the meaning of your research. I mean result, sorry. What is the meaning of your result? Because see, in result section, you have just put up a table, graph, something like that, and you are saying that this is your finding. But you are not describing here that what it is actually. Probably you will do this activity here in a discussion section where you are trying to inform to the reader that what is the meaning of your result. Okay, so interpretation of your result will be done in the first few lines under this discussion section. Okay, now see, you will not be using these headings in your paper. Do not write interpretation and sentence summary and then nothing like that. You are not going to write these blue colored headings. They are for our purpose. These blue colored headings I have written to just explain you. Okay, but here you will be directly in starting interpretation of your results under the discussion section. Okay, then you have to gradually justify that why your results are very valuable. Okay, so for that purpose, you have to answer this question: how does this result fit into the existing research? That means now you are going to compare your results with the results of other. For example, foundry people. So foundry people, first you have started interpretation of your result. Means what are the different results you obtained? What is their meaning? Why it is increasing? Why it is decreasing? Some parameter, why it is increasing? Why, say in graph, why that graph is say in increasing, decreasing? Why that graph is flat? Or if you use the table, you are talking about the table, about why the numbers in the table are gradually increasing, decreasing, whatever. So you are going to write the interpretation of the result here, and gradually you will compare your results with the past researchers. So here you will take the reference of the other papers, and you will say that in other paper they found this, but we found this, so therefore our results are close to those results, something like that, or how they are better, or maybe comparison, or maybe analysis. Okay, so those things gradually you will highlight in a second part of the discussion. So first part is interpretation, writing the meaning of the result. Second part is convincing that how your results are valuable by doing comparison or analysis. And in third part, gradually you have to mention that how this result is important. Valuable and important have same meaning, but then here you can try to connect with the industry. Maybe some research is done in the laboratory. For example, inverter, you design the inverter, okay, and then you have to connect here in the third part how this inverter is useful for solar power applications particularly, or something like that. So gradually you are now trying to convince your reader that it has a very good industry application and it is very useful to the society. So in that, so you have got now third part here basically. So first part was interpretation of the result. Second part was how your result is valuable, where you have compared your result with the other existing results. And in third part, you are trying to convince to the readers that how it is useful from the society point of view, industry point of view, and environmental point of view. For example, foundry people are working on, say, energy auditing. So here you will say that yes, how this result is very important from environment point of view, because day by day there is a degradation of environment due to the excessive use of the energy resources. And then since you have done some research and that research is useful from environment viewpoint, that way you have to write this third paragraph. Okay, and now limitations of results, because your results you found with certain assumptions. There were some assumptions. You have done some energy auditing, so you were having some assumptions that you used some meter or some methodology which were having some limitations, because you cannot go and check the temperature of furnace by putting thermometer. Okay, so you have used thermal recorder. So those limitations, or maybe similar other limitations which you have which you were having, and accordingly you have mentioned the assumptions also. So you got the result, and you found that those results might have some inaccuracies or maybe some errors, but you should be very smart to convince that that limitation is not very very important, or that limitation is not going to affect your results to larger extent. So those things, because see, you are trying to prove that how honest and sincere you are, so that reader will know that this is the research done and it does not have a fake numbers, fake details. Okay, and your discussions should be concluded with a conclusion. So the last sentence of your, or small paragraph, your conclusion section will be the conclusion of entire discussion.
So short conclusion to emphasize how findings are relevant in the context of, that means you are still again trying to convince that how your results are very important to the research which is already going on. Okay, so this is how, see, there are, I told you, some 3 to 4 parts you have to use in order to write your discussion section. So interpretation, then it's analysis, comparison with other researches, then it's impact or its importance, industry application, and then the last part is the limitation, and then you are also concluding. So these many segments, but remember, as I said in the beginning, do not use these headings explicitly. I mean, you should not write interpretation and start writing, integration and start writing, implication, start writing, nothing like that. These are all things to be written without any heading, but maybe you can have some paragraphs also just to separate these different parts. Hope this is convincing to you. Okay, I will leave these slides here, that how you should have first paragraph of a discussion written, in what way your sentence may start. These are some sentences you may use here when you start writing. Okay, fine. You just go through, because the first part summarize. First paragraph, summarize your article up to this point. Okay, fine. So you just, I have already told you many things. Just go through. These are different parts basically I'm talking about. See, interpretation, integration, implication, and limitation. So they're further, you know, elaborated here. So instead of me going in detail, I want you to read. You can take a pause here. You can pause the video while you watch this. Read this accordingly. Try how it is connected to your research paper. Limitations. I told you, you should be very smart enough to point out the limitations, and yet you are convincing that your limitations are not going to matter much, right? And this is how you can configure the sentences by using this kind of wordings, lines, and so on. And we are now last part. I mean, the summary and conclusion. You are going to conclude, okay? So I have a best idea for you. You have written these you know, sections in your paper. You have written introduction. You have written methodology section. You have written result and discussion section. So I have a good idea for you to write a conclusion. How you do? Just write down few lines of entire introduction section. Suppose you have written introduction section using 2 pages. Suppose. Just write down 4 to 5 lines of entire introduction section in the first part of conclusion section. So your conclusion section essentially consists of 3 paragraphs. So the first paragraph of your conclusion section is summary of introduction section. So as I said, your introduction section consists of 2 pages. Write down just 6 to 7 lines of entire introduction section that constitutes the first paragraph of conclusion section. Then for methodology, suppose you have used 1 or 2 pages. Okay, so just write down 6 to 7 lines of entire methodology section that constitutes second paragraph of your conclusion section. And result and discussion section was consisting of, say, for example, 2 pages. Write down 4 to 5 lines of result and discussion section, and that constitutes your third paragraph of conclusion section. So see, this is a good strategy you can use to write a conclusion section. It will not be very so short, and it will not be very large also, but it will give a clear screenshot of your entire research paper. Remember, there is no copy paste of introduction section lines, no copy paste from the method section lines, no copy paste from the discussion section. You are rewriting, reproducing same information in a short form using 6-7 lines for each paragraph, but in a different language with same meaning. that represents your conclusion section, and the last section is the future scope. So you should write what are the future, what additional things you can do. Okay, so future, you have to give idea to the researchers or readers that yes, still your paper or quality of paper can be improved by doing more research. So you are creating window for reader that you can jump into the research and I'm giving you some ideas. So give more ideas. So that is how you have to do. Okay, all these references, see, while you write this entire paper, every time you have used the references. So these references you have to start collecting, accumulating in the reference section. Okay, so I think I have done with this is all probably or higher end. This is your guide. You can talk to your guide where you should submit your journal.